Hey everyone, before we get into this video, I've got some updates I wanted to share with you. Things have been extremely busy since my last video. I went to the Commercial UAV Expo in Vegas just to see if there was anything new in the industry. I think FLIR had the best announcement of the show with their new thermal drone. My group as a whole has been really busy flying a lot of projects. I was fortunate enough to get my hands on one of the very first production units of the EcoFlow power kit for RVs, vans, off-grid type applications. We have 4 kilowatts of power that I installed in the van, and that's been a game changer for drone operations. We pretty much have power for anything we need now. I got it installed just in time for a mobile mapping project we were doing. So I was using the AC and DC output to power an NC Tech camera, Regal Vux, pavement smoothness or roughness inspection system, laptops, tablets, cameras, you name it. We pretty much had everything running on it. So that's been a game changer for us and really something that I had to dig into and get set up right. Would you like to see any content about the van power system, the van in progress build, trade show or travels, any of that stuff? Let me know in the comments and I'd be happy to upload some of that content. I've been pretty much collecting content with everything we do. So I've got a lot of stuff that I may or may not end up using or uploading. Done a lot of aerial topographic surveys over the past month. Some large ones too. I had a 10,000 acre and a 7,500 acre site back to back. We used manned aircraft to collect the data. And then we still did all the ground classification, the ortho, and all the planimetrics. So we've been quite busy. This video is about flight planning with the Astro. I've rewritten the script several times. I've reshot the video 3 times. And I even have a couple of edits of this video. And it's not so much about being perfect for this as much as it was my experience growing with using the Astro. You'll hear a little bit in this video about the long day that I had and continuous operations with the Astro. We have an 1800 acre project coming up this week that we're gonna fly the Astro with, so I'm sure we'll learn even more and our experiences will continue to grow and evolve. I'll get into everything a little bit deeper in a moment. Lastly, I wanted to let you know that FreeFly reached out to me after my last video. They wanted to make sure they clearly understood my issues, offer any potential solutions to the issues I pointed out. They've been great to interact with. I've had a few more things pop up since the video that I've shared with them. Most of my issues with the Astro are not things that are in FreeFly's control. My goal is not to shame or harm anyone with these videos, and I believe my discussions with FreeFly have been very productive and will help ultimately have a better Astro for all of us. So I really am happy that we're moving things along with that. All right, so let's move on to what it's like to plan a mission for the Astro. What's going on, everyone? I hope you're all doing well. Hopefully you know me and my quest to find suitable replacements for my DJI drones. But if not, welcome to the channel and check out some of my prior content. This video is all about flight planning and mapping with the FreeFly Astro. I'm gonna cover my preferred workflow as well as the Astro workflow with its nuances. My script and some of the takes for this video just got tossed. That's because they are OBE, overcome by events. I'll still be talking about flight planning with the FreeFly Astro, but I need to fill you on what really shaped the content of this video. It's story time. I'll make this quick, but bear with me for a moment. Do you ever have a day coming up at work you know is gonna suck? You have to really grind and push hard to make something happen. Friday was that day for me. Most of my surveying and mapping work is supporting civil engineering, land development, or utility existing condition as-built surveys. It's rare that I have an emergency project, but Friday was that day. So, okay, we have an emergency. First question, where is the project? That makes a 5-hour one-way commute. Not ideal, but okay. Can you send me the project extents? Oh, that's right next to an airport. Like the property abuts the airport property, and it's in the approach. Super not ideal because now the risk with us and manned aviation is higher and I need my more experienced crew members. They're working on other projects, so I'll have to change schedules. Again, not ideal. Can you send me the design for the project so I can plan out our ground control? No. Okay, we'll have to figure that out on the field. So flight lines, ground control, on site, not ideal, but okay. What's the area of the immediate concern in this project? Is it 20, 50, 100 acres? No, it's 400 acres. We handle 400 acre projects all the time. We have the experience, equipment, and expertise, but for an emergency must get done today project, 400 acres is not ideal. We'll have to get a safety briefing on site. Okay, that's normal for active construction projects, but for an emergency project that's not exactly small, A safety briefing eats into daylight and flying time. It's a little more not ideal. Okay, let's recap what I know before headed into this day. 5-hour drive to the site, so that likely means leaving home at 4 a.m., meet the project team, get a safety briefing, plan out ground control and the flight lines after looking at the site map once on site, meet the project surveyor, then send him where we put our targets so he can locate them, find suitable places to fly from, fly 400 acres with the Astro, and to be honest, I'm not entirely confident with yet because I don't have the experience with the aircraft, so I feel like my proficiency is not where I would want it to be for a mission critical flight. Hopefully finish up flying around 6 p.m., sign out of the job site, then be back on the road around 7 p.m. for a 5-hour commute. Get home close to midnight, closing out a 20-hour workday. Not ideal, but for an urgent emergency, it's all possible. I love my work, I love my job, but this is the kind of day that truly sucks. That said, it's a fantastic opportunity for my team, our company, and to really help out a client that needs help. I'm curious, drop me a comment if you have days like this, and I'm really interested to how often emergency flights pop up for you. They're a big reason why I avoid like the on-call service contracts. Okay, so for the topic of this video, there's a lot of ways to do drone mapping depending on your specific needs. I'm not proclaiming that my way is the best way, but I'm gonna share a bit of my way with you. My preferred workflow for photo mapping typically starts with a quote request that includes the project's extents in KML format. I use the KML and my ground station software to plan the operation so I understand how much time it's going to take to fly. I put in the flight altitude, overlap, side lap, speed, and then I save that plan mission. The next step is to plan out ground control, I think is needed for this specific project. I keep the planned mission, ground control, and everything, and I build a detailed proposal. I use all of the info to build a detailed proposal, and I keep the planned mission, ground control layout, and the pricing buildup with all the proposal information. I've used this basic workflow with DJI Ground Station Pro, the DJI Pilot for P4RTK, Mission Planner, and Q Ground Control. Ground Station Pro is nice for saving missions to the cloud and syncing missions from the cloud, so I could plan in the office with an iPad, and then the pilot in the field could open the plan with a different iPad. That was handy and really efficient. This may or may not be what you do, but it's worked well for me. When we are awarded a project, I go to the proposal folder and open up the proposed flight and ground control to verify it's still all good. Sometimes I change it, sometimes I don't. When it's time to do the ground control field work, we open up the plan, and sometimes when you get to the field, there's a reason you may need to make changes. They can adjust the planned ground control or even the flight lines. My field crews have the experience and flexibility to do as they see fit. Most of the time, they do not need to change anything, but being able to is a big part of getting it done right. So let's use the Astro and Auterion Mission Control app on the herelink with my workflow. Okay, so I have a project. Let's import the KML extent so we can see the flight time. So in AMC, you go to the plan menu and you're gonna hit pattern, pick survey, and then load KML shape. There's no ability to access the SD card I put the KML on or browse the Android file system. I'll have to draw the extents manually. Before Friday, this would have been something I said is inconvenient, but with what we needed to get done, it's a big deal. Friday's project location was a solid tree form and all satellite imagery that I could find from all providers. So I had no idea where the extents of the project visually lined up with the site boundary. So at this point, I have no choice but to leave the herelink version of AMC and move on to the computer to plan in the computer version of AMC. The computer version of AMC does allow you to browse and import KML. So then I set my altitude, speed, overlap, and voila. I have an approximate time it will take to fly this project. This is good, I need to save it. On the computer, you can save it. On the herelink with the AMC app, again, you can't save it to the Android file system or the SD card, so it's stuck in the app on the device. I export my flight lines from the AMC app so I can plan ground control on Google Earth. The computer version this works, but the same problem exists on the herelink RC version. It's not possible. I'll cover the operation and experience for mapping in another video soon. However, I will tell you, on Friday we did have some challenges, and we did fly the drone using AMC on the laptop with the FreeFly RTK module using an average sphere position for all 400 acres. That means herelink had to run the AP hotspot as well as be plugged in the whole day. That adds a bit of heat on the RC and a bit of praying that it would not power off because of overheating. Not a feeling I enjoy. If you like this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing. My goal is to help everyone who is needing to find non-DJI drones. The more awareness we can create around the pros and cons of all the current options available, the more we can help manufacturers refine their products to fit our collective needs.